Football players at their peak are more than just stars, but also role models to their fans' kids and great ambassadors to their countries and clubs. I will boldly say, much is expected from them when it comes to drug usage. But it's not always so, as some footballers push into taking drugs to keep fit, which is against the FIFA rules and regulations. Today we will be talking about famous players accused of taking drugs to boost their game strength. Without wasting time, please subscribe to our channel. It does not take anything to help subscribe. Thanks. On number 1, is Kolo Touré. Kolo Touré was an excellent defender who has played for 3 English Gant club, which includes Arsenal, Manchester City and Liverpool. He was also a team player for Ivory Coast. Kolo tested positive to a banned substance during his time at Manchester City and was placed on a 6-month ban by the English Football Association. Touré's side of the story was, he mistakenly took the banned substance from his wife's diet pills, and although the English FA later saw reasons to believe Touré, the ban wasn't lifted till after the 6 months. Did you know that Pep Guardiola, the great manager, rated our number 2 here? Well, before becoming a great manager, the midfielder failed a drug test back in 2001, Pep test to nandrolone, which is a banned substance. This was seen running through the city boss blood, but the usual Guardiola battled his way with the Football Association, taking the case to a whole 6 years length to Deschede, which he won in 2007. The case came up again the following year, but Pep won the case and finally cleared all cases and name in 2009. Diego Maradona, you probably heard of his drug case, but few things you should pick from his drug case is, it happened in 1991 while at Napoli, and the Argentina legend was issued a 15-month ban. Maradona didn't just tested positive to any drugs, he tested positive to cocaine. Before then he was Napoli star man and still stand a legend to the Italian club, who named their stadium after Diego Maradona. And also, Maradona was the best Argentina player until the arrival of the GOAT, Lionel Messi, who Maradona confirmed himself to be the greatest of all time. On number 5, we have the popular Edgar Davis. You all know the man that Paul is with dark shades on and a full-grown dratted hair. Well, the mid-fighter tested positive to anabolic steroid nandrolone back in Juventus in 2001. He was placed on a 6-month ban, but Davis denies ever taking the drug. In his words, "I have never taken any illegal substances in my entire life, I never took nandrolone, I am always against any type of doping and I have always been loyal to sport, I have never even thought of the possibility of using kind of doping." Finally on our list today, we have André Mutu. Although this famous player spent just 1 season at Chelsea, it was enough reason for him to curse a whole load of controversies, ranging from falling out with his manager, Jose Mourinho, and termination of his contract by Chelsea when he finally tested positive and failed the drug test. Well, for Mutu and with his high temper, it was not a surprise that he tested positive for cocaine. This served him a 7-month ban from football. He resumed the game at Fiorentina. But funny enough, Mutu failed another drug test in 2010. This time his ban increased to 9 months and Fiorentina didn't take time to end his contract with them. Thanks for watching and hope you enjoyed the video. Feel free to add yours to the comment room. And please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel for more football gist. Have a great day ahead.